It is now post E3. There has been a lot that's been presented this year at E3. There's been new games that have been announced at this release. Dead Rising 4, Gears of War 4, more of The Last Guardian, but for this video in particular, we're going to talk about Hideo Kojima's Death Stranding. I will be releasing more E3 videos on my channel, so make sure you subscribe to keep up with all of those videos. This game took a lot of us at surprise. This game has been in development for some time by Kojima himself, and published by Sony. Now, a lot of you might know that Kojima did leave Konami last year of 2015 and joined up with Sony under their independent company, Kojima Productions. Now, Kojima Productions is an independent company and is not owned by Sony, but they are working on this game, Death Stranding, with Sony. Now, before I get into the game too deep, I want to explain that I am a massive fan of Hideo Kojima's work. Hideo Kojima is a great inspiration to me, as he is to others. He has made great works in the past, the Metal Gear series, and he has a lot to offer to the community of video game development. He has a great mind, and he's extremely intelligent, so I'm pretty excited to see what this game is going to offer. Now, under the Kojima Productions company name, the new independent company name, they started working with Sony to make this new game series, which is now called Death Stranding, to release as an exclusive for the PS4 system. Near the end of PlayStation's E3 conference, PlayStation did announce Kojima's new title. During the trailer, you see somewhat of a post-apocalyptic world, probably sometime in the far future. There's a lot of hidden meaning in this trailer. I'm sure everyone's gonna acknowledge and look through it carefully, and there is already a lot of people doing that now. The trailer itself is very psychological. There's a lot of futuristic stuff in this trailer, as you can see. There's a futuristic handcuffs. Throughout the trailer, you finally realize who the actual protagonist is, Norman Reedus. Now, Reedus was a big part of Kojima's history in the last year, as he was working with P.T. and Silent Hills with him and Guillermo del Toro. Now, we'll get back to P.T. and Silent Hills in a second, but I want you to keep a close eye on the umbilical cord between Norman Reedus and this baby near him. Now, if you all know Kojima, he likes to trick people and give them a great twist to each one of his stories that he creates. Now, I'm sure there's some sort of hidden meaning between the baby and Norman Reedus, because they are connected by that umbilical cord. If you guys aren't clear about how pregnancy and birth works, usually a woman carries a baby, but by what the looks of this, looks like Norman Reedus had him in his belly. His belly, yes, I said belly. During the Death Stranding trailer, we do see a lot of fish and whales that are beached onto the island that Norman Reedus is located on. The word Death Stranding comes from the word cetacean stranding. This is a phenomenon where marine mammals such as whales beach themselves. After the conference, Kojima did do an interview about Death Stranding. Kojima did explain that the reference Death Stranding is for this reason. It might also explain why Norman Reedus is also stranded on this island and left alone. During the interview, Kojima also explained a little more of the game. Kojima did not specify a specific game genre, but he did explain that there's going to be a lot of action. Kojima continues saying, "It's something completely different than what the audience is used to. It seems like the game's release window is not close, and it is not connected to PT. Kojima also explained that the Kojima Productions logo, which is the mascot, has nothing to do with this game. Guillermo del Toro is also not included into this production. Back in the playable teaser, PT, that was created in 2014, there was a little baby in there, a little actual fetus. During the trailer, I couldn't help but think that this baby that Norman Reedus is holding has some connection to the baby in PT. The fetus. Now, I know that probably has nothing to do with PT. Kojima even explains that it's not connected to PT in any way. I like to think that this baby is connected to Norman Reedus' character in PT. A lot of people are also thinking metaphorically about this baby, like Kojima's breakup with Konami in the past, hints for the baby being gone in the trailer. Perhaps Norman Reedus' character is Hideo Kojima and the baby is PT, therefore Kojima lost the project he truly loved, Silent Hills. Since the release of the trailer, there's also been a poster up for Death Stranding showing this, Norman Reedus, and of course the title of the game. Not only did people look closely to the trailer, but some looked closely to this poster, especially to the dog tags. According to Redditor Tomas146, if you zoom in close enough to these dog tags, there's two clear equations on them. One is the Dirac equation, and the other, the Schwarzschild radius. Both of these equations together relate to relativity and quantum mechanics. What does this mean exactly? I'm not really sure, but it does point more towards a futuristic genre to the game. Now, there's not a whole lot of information to go off based off this trailer and what information we do have now, but it only has just been announced. But one thing is for sure, Kojima does have a lot up his sleeve, and I'm sure a lot of us are excited to see what that is. If you liked the video, click the like button down below. Also subscribe for more E3 footage. What was your favorite E3 game that was announced, or your favorite moment from E3 this year, 2016? What do you think Death Stranding is all about? Put down in the comment what you guys think, and if you guys want me to discuss more on this game, please let me know and I can make a part 2. Thank you guys.